Streetscapes is an installation project that we conceived in response to COVID. It was a project that we came up with last fall, in the fall of 2020, when we were expecting fellows here, but we really didn't know what the spring would bring. And we were worried about an indoor exhibition that we would have to cancel or limit to the public. So we came up with the idea of Streetscapes, a project that would invite our fellows to develop artworks that would be accessible to the public from the street. These projects are linked by the need to be visible to the general public from the street. And it's interesting how the different artists have faced that challenge. In the case of Sara Enrico and Corina Gosmaro, they both made work that is situated behind a fence or a gate. Sara's work is positioned on the front lawn of the Academy, and it floats above the ground, sort of plays with the architecture behind it, and it has a very buoyant light feel to it. And so she's really presented it so from the outside people are able to see it even without getting up close. Sara Enrico works in fabric, which she prints with images made out of scans. There's this complex relationship between an original image, a scanned image, a printed image, and then she folds these fabrics, which are essentially the sort of lycra that we see in athletic wear, and she forms it around molds that are carved out of a foam core. And so she creates these sort of beautiful, soft, floating sculptures that play against each other. If you look closely, they're actually carved out of a single piece of this foam material. So in your mind, you might be able to reassemble them into one piece. And that allows us also to imagine them playing out in different moments, in different choreographic patterns. She's really thinking about folding. She's talks about the importance of the fold, of juxtapositions and repetitions. And she's spoken about Rome as a city that really plays out on that motif of folding and the way it's layered upon itself many times over. So her work, I think, fits really well. It situates itself beautifully in front of our architecture. It is architectonic, but it's also light and playful and surprising in many ways. I find it very joyful work.
In my time here in Rome, I've been interested in looking at the incredible amount of obelisks that network the city of Rome, and to think about this recurring monumental form, this seemingly irreducible singular form, and instead to unpack its many alternative valences and to consider the obelisk as a starting point in a kind of a history of uncertainty in architecture. My installation for Streetscapes is called A Mutual Involution of Things, and it brings the Vatican obelisk into the cortile of the American Academy in Rome. The title draws from Marcus Aurelius's Meditations, where he talks about the universe as either being a mutual involution of things or unity and order. What I'm interested in is this idea of involution and the possibility of cacophony and multiplicity producing a different kind of monumentality, one that moves against the kind of authority of form or the hegemony of form. The installation is a one-to-one replica of the Vatican obelisk that stretches from one end of the cortile to the other. Upon entering the courtyard, a white, light, hollow, levitating form stretches taut from end to end, and below it and dislodged from it is a magenta shadow projected from its former standing position. What these two elements do to one another is to set into tension, into motion, the kind of fixity or the singularity of a single reading in the space. Of course, the sun changes throughout the day and many more shadows come into play in engagement with the installation. One of the things that struck me in thinking about the obelisks and the way that they behave in the city is the incommensurability of their form in plan and in elevation. In plan, they're single points, dots, the tiniest forms, and in elevation, they are these looming figures that call to you in the city. As we approach them, they almost disappear as they rise to the sky, and it is only the shadow on the surface of the piazzas that's left to kind of suggest the enormity of their scale. This is a very curious thing to me, the idea of an object that is so strange, that is, in a way, the biggest small thing and the smallest big thing. So I was interested in what would happen in turning the vertical into a horizontal in the cortile and making that scale measurable by the body, the entirety of that length. I was interested in seeing what happens in bringing the monument in and bringing the body into proximity with this monumentality. The project inverts our typical relationship to the object in the city. Essentially, it's turning the city in on itself. It's bringing the urban scale into the residential, domestic scale, institutional scale. But this inversion goes further. When we come upon an obelisk, we are interested not only in the thing itself, but in all of those invisible things that made it possible for this thing to be here. The networks of labor, material, transportation, knowledge, precarity, intelligence that have brought this thing into being, this kind of implausible element. And I was interested as much in these invisible structures as I am in the thing itself. And so the material choices for the installation are really evocative of that. So using scaffolding netting and using garden pavers as a way of bringing the language of construction into proximity with the forms and the metaphysics of these monumental forms.
Corinna installed her work in the very intimate space in front of Bramante's Tempietto at the Piazza di San Pietro in Montorio, and we're really grateful to the Spanish Academy for giving us access to that site. Her works are very small sculptures. They're sort of these insect creatures, and you have to get very close, come right up to the grate and look down to find them. So you've got this play between these small, provocative sculptures and this monumental, very famous backdrop. So she's really playing with that invitation in and the need to look closely. The works she's created for the space at the Tempietto are a combination of cord, a sort of thick mountain climber's cord, and bronze casts of rope. So there's this beautiful play of materials, and she creates these, I find them at once funny, amusing, but also disturbing and slightly scary creatures. She titles her work Chutzpah, which is a Yiddish term that means a little irreverent, a little sassy, and slightly menacing, but also playful at the same time. And the play of these sculptures against this monumental, famous, iconic architecture, I think is particularly effective.
Landscape è un progetto partito attraverso l'opportunità della residenza presso l'American Academy. Il termine nuovissimo sta ad indicare la necessità del paesaggio di essere continuamente nel presente e quindi di essere continuamente ridiscusso. Il paesaggio, per essere, ha bisogno della nostra presenza, della presenza umana, oltre che dello spazio che ci circonda. Il progetto qui si è sviluppato alternando grandi attraversamenti nel Parco della Appia Antica con attraversamenti minuti all'interno della stanza, che è lo studio. E in realtà questa oscillazione tra interno ed esterno, impressione ed espressione del paesaggio, è un modo per seguire una fluttuazione del progetto e del processo di attraversamento del paesaggio, laddove anche la dimensione di interiorità ed esteriorità e la loro divisione è messa in discussione. E nel senso che la stanza, in questo caso la stanza fisica, ma in realtà la stanza del paesaggio è soprattutto e prima di tutto astratta, diventa quindi un contenitore che intercetta non tanto le forme quanto il loro divenire, partendo dal presupposto che nulla è fermo nella sua forma, ma tutto è sottoposto ad un continuo processo di trasformazione e anche ovviamente deperimento. Portare all'interno della stanza gli elementi arbustivi provenienti dal Parco dell'Appia Antica fa parte sempre di quella oscillazione tra attraversare il paesaggio ma anche farsi attraversare dal paesaggio. Il divenire delle forme viene impresso su questi grandi tessuti che hanno anche un livello di trasparenza, come se le specie arbustive, come se le forme del paesaggio dall'esterno si fossero impresse o fossero state intercettate da questa superficie. E ovviamente poi non ne rimangono le fattezze concluse, finite, ma rimane ciò che resta in questo passaggio attraverso la superficie. Nella Villa Panfili, per Streetscapes, il titolo Nuovissimo Landscape si trasforma in Nuovissimo Landscape Goes Silver, perché quando il progetto esce fuori dalla stanza fisica, allora diventa una linea astratta, sintetica. Si tratta di una maglia reticolare e quindi quattro pini possono formare una stanza ovviamente astratta. Avvolgere i quattro pini con una banda argentata composta da una serie di coperte termiche vuol dire evidenziare prima di tutto l'importanza della presenza con noi della stanza del paesaggio. Queste coperte termiche, queste bande argentate diventano il riverbero e anche il fruscio, perché sono talmente leggere che anche con un filo di vento iniziano a suonare in qualche modo. E allo stesso tempo, essendo argentate, sono come degli specchi soffici che non riflettono le forme, ma piuttosto riflettono la luce e quindi i colori delle forme, quindi questo le rende invisibili ma allo stesso tempo visibili. In qualche modo questo materiale spinge ad ascoltare la presenza continua del fruscio del paesaggio.
Our goal with Streetscapes was to give our artists a chance to work, to realize their projects while they were in Rome, to share them with Romans. It also worked out that all of their installations were located right around our institution. And that's really a great thing, because I think we see people walk by the Academy all the time and they're often not sure what it is. And I hope that this installation can help make the Academy more visible to Rome and especially to our neighbors up here on the Janiculum Hill around Monteverde and in Trastevere. So we hope that despite the constraints of the COVID era, we've been able to use this time to connect with Rome, connect our artists with Rome, and build on the mission that really drives us here at the American Academy.